Hello, and welcome to this video on how to crack the coding interview. In this video, I'm going to help you build strategy so that you can prepare for your next interview. Our main focus will be on how we can optimize the use of lead code and cracking the coding interview book. Stay with me for the last of this video as I'll be sharing some important resources throughout. I assume that you have the knowledge of basic data structures like linked list, stack, queue, binary tree, and of course arrays. If you are the first time visitor to my channel, then please go and hit the subscribe button. We will start with lead code and then move to cracking the coding interview book. The strategy is going to be much similar. Lead code is the best platform to help you enhance your skills, expand your knowledge, and prepare for technical interviews. If you have time, then please read the articles on lead code. They are a great source of information for knowing and understanding the interview process in different companies. People who have been interviewed by different companies write these articles to share their experience. The stories contributed are both of success and failure. I have shared the links of some great articles that I found is useful for your preparation. If you have the premium membership, you can practice the questions grouped by company names, which sometimes helps you understand the standards of the question asked by these companies. Since most students are not able to afford the premium membership, we will discuss all our strategies even for non-premium members, how we can utilize lead code at its best. Let me be honest, I was not very good at competitive coding, though I was equipped with problem-solving skills. I was more involved in development, working with mobile applications, web apps, and making games on Unity Engine. The strategy that I'm going to discuss with you really helped me a lot to improve my interview-based coding skills to a great extent. I created this Google Sheet when I was preparing for my interview. Whenever I solve new questions on lead code or CTCI book, I used to log some details about it in this sheet. This helps me keep track of my progress and boost my confidence to another level. Even earlier, I practiced coding, but was never able to build confidence in myself. I felt like I'm not able to solve many questions. I doubted myself for being eligible for coding interviews, but that's an older story. Let's start discussing the Google Sheet with you. I used to write the date about when I solved this question. This helps me maintain consistency and build a habit of solving questions every day. This is something toughest to achieve and meanwhile most important for your interview preparation. Next, I write the source of the question so that I can refer it back easily without wasting time in searching for it again and again. Then comes the difficulty level of the question. The motive behind writing this step is that you can analyze yourself about your own potentials and push yourself out of your comfort zone. And again, this is the confident boost factor. As you move from easy to medium to hard level, you can visualize your progress and feel good about it. Next, we have focus time. This is crucial for your interview. You get 45 minutes to solve a problem in an interview. If you don't have any strategy, then there is a higher chance of failure. So what is the strategy to get most out of this time? It is simple, build a habit. In the first 10 minutes, you don't have to write any line of code. Just read the question and make yourself understand it in layman terms. Then try to find the brute force or naive solution to your question. Think of the possible edge cases. Dedicate this 10 minutes very wisely. Try to write the code that you came up with within the next 25 minutes. Utilize the remaining 10 minutes for reviewing and cleaning your code. This will add extra credibility to your solution. You can use your mobile stopwatch or Google timer for setting reminders. If your time is up and you think that you can still solve the problem, then start the stopwatch and see how much more time you need to solve it. But if you are not able to find any clue, then go and see the solution and read it for 10 minutes. You can find most of the solution on lead code. If a solution is not found, then you can come back here, comment on the video, and write the question you want to discuss. To get notified about my videos, please subscribe and hit the bell icon. Let's get back to our sheet. Next is results. Write the results of your submission so that you remember which questions were solved by you in your first attempt. If it is solved by you now, then you can also solve the same questions after weeks or months. Take three colors in consideration: red if not solved, yellow if partially solved, and finally green if solved in first attempt. If you were able to solve the questions after reading the solution, what it means is you understand the concept behind the questions and just were not able to think of the solution at that moment, you can give these questions a different color code. Next time, when you visit these questions again, go for the purple one first, then yellow, and finally the red one. Next, add the number of times you visited the questions and finally in a day and total number of problems that you were able to solve on a particular day. Try to find a quiet place and fix time to practice your skills. Remember, consistency is the key to success. Let's discuss what are the problems that you need to solve on LeetCode. Go to problem section on LeetCode and apply the following filters. Select the difficulty level of coding, and once you start feeling comfortable, move to the next level. Remember, you don't have to solve all the questions here. From list, selected the top interview questions. Next, start solving problems and follow the steps that we discussed earlier. Now, let's discuss some strategies on how to work with cracking the coding interview book. This book is Bible for interview preparation. Though not compulsory, but I would suggest you to read section 2, behind the scenes, of this book. It is quite interesting and will give you an insight on how the big tech companies conduct interviews. This will make you more familiar with the interview process. My next suggestion would be to read section 7, technical questions of this book. This section will discuss the strategy that you should know while solving the questions. Remember, these are not necessary for you to read, but it's worth reading. The important one comes next. Go to section 9, interview questions of this book, and start solving questions in breadth-first manner. Don't deep dive into any topic. Start solving a few questions from each chapter within this section. That is, start from first chapter to last chapter, again get back to the first chapter. Make it a cyclic process. If you get stuck, go and see the hints given at the back of this book. This is the beauty of this book. It actually gives you a real interview experience. In an interview also, when you're stuck, the interviewer gives you a hint. Never hesitate to ask the interviewers whenever you get stuck. Let me share the final resource with you. You can refer to this repository for solution of CTCI book. It is highly recommended to solve the questions by yourself. But if you're stuck for long, you can refer back here. At this place, you can find solutions in different programming languages, and even you can contribute to this repository. The link is given in the description for you. To summarize, start solving the interview questions from LeetCode or CTCI book. In the first 10 minutes, try to come up with a brute force solution. Write code in the next 25 minutes. Finally, clean and reorganize your content. Thank you all for watching this video. Please help me by subscribing to my channel, clicking on the subscribe button, and press the bell icon to get notified about my new videos. Thank you again. See you all in the next videos. Have a great day.